When I was growing up, there was always a constant pressure to excel in everything I did. This is how my mother raised me. I had to be the best of the best, and I was never really sure why. Specifically, I had to be an all-star student. This high expectation of me continued as I grew up, even when I was going through the hardest time of my life. When I was 16 years old, I lost my father to suicide. After that, I thought that maybe some of this pressure to perform would be relieved, and I would have some slack from my mother, and maybe I would have time to grieve. But that's not what happened. If anything, I felt like I had to be even more responsible about school and my life. Within the last year, I made a new friend named Linzy. She is 22 years old and a graduate student at Carlo. She also has two jobs. She kind of likes to take on as much as she possibly can, like I tend to do. It struck me how similar our personalities are, and I wondered if that had anything to do with how we were raised. She, too, understands parent mortality, but for different reasons than mine. So I asked Linzy about her childhood and if she was given a lot of responsibility. I thought that maybe her childhood could shed some light on my own.
Part 1. Truths.
When I look back on my childhood, I both see myself as having little and much responsibility. For instance, perhaps my parents never really taught me practical day-to-day skills like how to cook or do laundry or give me any sort of financial literacy lessons, but I suppose my parents saw these things as skills I would eventually teach myself. But have no question, my parents did not want me to be naive. They always made sure to tell me the truth about things. My mother has always had health problems for as long as I can remember, and even from an early age, I was told about death and how that's sort of a fact of life. And I know that's sort of a cryptic lesson for, you know, maybe a 7-year-old, but my parents told me a life truth. I'm 22 years old now, and my mom is still here, so perhaps she unnecessarily freaked me out a little, but I don't think that that was a bad life lesson to learn.
That was not a bad life lesson to learn. There are just certain facts of life, and unfortunately, death is one of them. Is being 7 years old and knowing about death too much to know? Is that too much for a child to handle? Is this too much knowledge? Well, let's get back to Linzy and hear her thoughts on the issue.
Of all of these life truths that my parents shared with me and entrusted to me, they were all to prepare me for reality. And because my parents never hid anything from me, I feel as if I was more responsible because I had the same level of knowledge as them. I'm thankful for this special sort of responsibility that my parents, you know, gave to me through knowledge. And I think that many kids today just don't get it from home and they have to find it themselves. And I just think that that's really sort of unfortunate because after living 22 years of my life, I can't really imagine experiencing that any other way. Something to be frightened of, and I could see it coming from the edge of the room, smiling in the street light, holding my hand in the pale gloom.
Part 2. Generations. A daughter and her mother. August 18th, 2007, my father hangs himself from a rope, taking his own life. August 27th, 2007, 9 days later, I'm starting my first day of junior year of high school. All the while, acting like nothing has changed. I can't let this minor setback affect my schooling and rank among class, after all. This is junior year, the most important academic year of my high school career. Colleges will be looking at my transcript and SAT scores. There's no time to grieve the loss of my father. This attitude has been forever instilled in me from the help of my mother. School is my job and my number one priority. I need to act as if I can take on the world, even if my world is crashing down.
When I was growing up, grades were not really stressed in my house. It really wasn't important if I did well or I didn't do well. They wanted me to do well and they praised me when I did, but there really wasn't consequences or anything if I did well or I didn't. I wanted to go to college and I was told that I could not go to college because it was too expensive, and my mother thought I should just go to business school and get a job. I wasn't allowed to drive because I was a girl, so I wasn't allowed to get my driver's permit or get my driver's license. My brother actually got his driver's license before I did because I was a girl and I didn't need to drive. So whenever I had my daughter, I wanted to teach her to be a very strong, independent woman and that could do everything for herself and on her own. I wanted her to not have to rely or count on anybody else for her independence or her finances or to tell her what she should think or do. It was important to me that she be strong on her own and not have to rely on anybody else.
Well, it would have been really great to hear that from my mother as I was growing up. I never heard the logic as to why I had to be such a responsible child. However, I can't be all that mad. I'm pretty confident that my mother kept me from a slippery slope. It's scary to imagine how different my life could be if I let my grief consume me. My mother kept me on the right track. Really, I think besides the obvious, like feed you and provide shelter, that's what parents are supposed to do. They keep you on the right track and make sure that no matter what, you do not get derailed until you're old enough to stay on path yourself. In a way, Linzy's parents kept her on the right track. They were always honest with her. Because of this, she was confident in herself growing up that she could handle the life that was ahead of her. I think that knowing why my mother was so insistent on me to do well and act so grown up would have made me less resistant. It's easy to see in retrospect that I'm better off now because of her, but during that time in my life, it was not so clear. Sometimes the truth can be messy or awkward or just hard to hear, but it's necessary. Whose word, especially when you're a child, do you value the most? It's your parents. Knowledge and life truths are beautiful things, and paired with responsibility and having a promising future, now that's exceptionally beautiful.